Hey guys, it's Brooke Chris, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool game over last summer. After I picked up the win in the Champions League over Celtic, and I picked up a narrow victory in the league over Bournemouth. And I also talked about the tragedy that happened last week to the Brazilian side. I also talked a little bit about Liverpool's recent unfortunate injuries to the likes of Philippe Coutinho. So as you can see, the first up is a home game against Middlesbrough, and this video is going up the 5th of December 2016, which is my 21st birthday. I would ask you to comment and happy birthday messages, but as I'm sure you've noticed this by now, I mean, how could you not have noticed this? I mean, I've been off for a while now. I've turned off my comments, and I will not be turning them back on, ever. Because on the rare occasion that I do get comments, I get comments like stupid comments and fucking idiots self-promoting.
Hi there, everybody. Martin Tyler here, along with Alan Smith.
I mean, I had heard that people like to self-promote. I've heard people be posting. I was actually he's the only one who did that before.
Maurice Karius is the goalkeeper.
It was only after I heard that annoyed YouTubers that I stopped doing it. I'd only done it a few times, just not realizing that they annoyed them. Then they probably just ignored the comment mostly.
I think that back four is really important.
So, yeah. And, by the way, everyone who... I tried to ignore it. You can see, like, if you go... I don't know if they're... No, I think the old videos that have comments on it, it's probably still... Those comments are probably still there. I think they should be still there. I mean, they were made before I disabled the comments. Maybe they got rid of them? I don't know. I haven't looked at a video that can give me those answers recently. But, I was trying to ignore it, and focus on, you know, them saying, oh, the video was good. You can catch out people who are just there for the self-promotion, because, you know, you can have someone say, oh, the video was amazing, and yet, just the like, he hasn't liked the video. Or she hasn't liked the video. Or they haven't liked the video. So, you're telling me the video was good, but you didn't like the video. And chances are, you didn't watch the full fucking thing. Because, I think some people think YouTubers are stupid. Because, if you're just there for the self-promotion, then fuck off. Why am I allowing you to just try and get your name out on my channel? So, yeah, it's done. I'm fucking done.
Here comes the cross.
I had to ban a lot of people over the past couple of days, because they just pissed me off, because it was blatantly obvious. Is I had reached my boiling point in terms of the self-promoting. And, you know, the blatantness. I mean, I can see the minutes watched on average of my video. I don't get a lot of views. So I can tell if someone has not watched the whole video.
Now the shot! Just
So don't come to me. If you've watched a few seconds of the video, just pause the video, fucking type in your little fucking comment, and think you're so fucking brilliant. And, he might fucking answer, he might fucking look at my page. No! If you ever ask me to look at anything, I have not fucking looked at it. Now, some people, I will give some people credit, some people, when they leave me links, were leaving me links to things like headsets, and mics, which I appreciate. I appreciate that. I appreciate people who are trying to better for this channel. And to you, and you probably know who you are if you're still watching me, thank you. And when I get the chance, I will look into better equipment. I mean, I don't know when that will be. I mean, I could realistically save up the money to invest in better equipment, but you have to remember, and I do want to specify this. This is not my job. I'm not doing this as a job. I don't make any money off this. I really don't. I make absolutely fucking nothing. I've not made 1 cent off of YouTube. So this is not my job. It's not gonna come my job anytime soon unless I blow up on YouTube, and not like in a blow up as in a dangerous sense. I mean, blow up as in become super popular, or get hundreds upon thousands of subscribers and views, whose my videos become some of the most popular videos on YouTube. That's just not gonna happen. So yeah, I do this as a hobby. This is a hobby. This is all that YouTube is. And I mean, some people do it as a job, and they're lucky to have the ability to do this as a job. I mean, you know, big YouTubers do this as their source of income because they get so many views and so many likes and so much people on each video, and hell, people even go back and watch old videos again and again. Which, I mean, I do as well. On the YouTubers I watch, I will go back and watch old videos because I really enjoyed those videos. And I'm just never gonna have that. I fully realize that. I'm not gonna sit here deluded and tell you, oh, I'm the best there is. I'm not. I'm nowhere near the best. I'm probably not even in the top 50 million. I don't even know if there are 50 million people on YouTube. There probably is. I mean, there's always 7, but there's about 8 billion people in the world, roughly. So, it could be 50 million on this website. I mean, you don't know. I don't know the exact numbers. I don't run this website. But there are so many people who always going to be better than me when it comes to content. And I know I don't have the best content. I know I'm not the top FIFA YouTuber. And I never will be. Because, well, I enjoy career mode. Career mode is not really popular. I mean, Ultimate Team is probably more popular in the FIFA community. Which is bizarre because, you know, FIFA would be dead and buried if not for career mode. No, let's not forget, because Ultimate Team only came in a few years ago, let's not forget. And up until, well, it did, what was the most popular game mode? Career mode. Because everyone played career mode because there was no alternative. There was no clubs, there was no, Ultimate Team. It was either play with your friends, play against the computer, or play career mode. Hey, or fuck off. Pretty much. And yet EA, despite all the games that career mode would have sold over the years, say, you know, thanks for all the money, career mode. Now you can fuck off and die, slowly die. We might pump a bit of life into you every now and again. But mostly we're going to pamper our new favourite child, Hulks that we named Ultimate Team.
Viewpoint on it. Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
Really? I mean, unless Kurimo becomes a way for... Unless they add something to where... I mean, they could do it. I mean, they don't have to make career mode. I mean, so I've heard people talk about this, adding some thing into career mode where EA could make some money off of career mode. Because then, if EA makes some money off of career mode, what a goal from Roberto Firmino, by the way. Take a bow, son. I wish there was a bow for celebration. Because that would be freaking hilarious. There probably is, and I just don't know how to do it. What was I talking about? Yeah, if you add that option, and... You know, some people will say, oh, it's going to ruin career mode. No. It really it doesn't have to. It just depends on what EA would do with it. I mean... Like... Say... I got it. Say a player gets injured.
The game gets underway.
EA could add in that you can get a heal player or thing that, you know, you can buy like an instant heal for that player. You can instantly heal player. The player will be instantly healed and it'll cost. EA can come up with a semi-reasonable fee. Nothing too big. Hey, just a nice piece of me. Hey.
Time ticking on.
Hey. $1 or £1 or €1. Just an instant heal. Maybe that's too cheap. I don't know. EA could spitball with that idea. That way. Because players get injured all the time, and sometimes it's outside of matches. I mean, I have lost count how many players have gotten injured in training, and it's just so annoying. If EA added something like that, or, I mean, it's similar to Ultimate Team, where you can, like, get some, if a player gets injured, instead of waiting for that player to be healed, like, okay, just buy an instant healing card. And while, you know, obviously not using cards, because this is career mode, not Ultimate Team, I'm not suggesting turning career mode into Ultimate Team. That would just say, that would just bring out the Ultimate Team nerds in fucking drones to say, oh, they're fucking copying what they're doing on Ultimate Team, on career mode. This is a fucking outrage. That's an Ultimate Team feature. That's Ultimate Team. That's for Ultimate Team only. No career mode. I fucking guarantee you, you would get people like that. You fucking, I guarantee fucking to you, man. Guarantee fucking to it, because there are some people, like, no, Ultimate Team fans are complete fucking imbecile, but just people just don't have an open mind when it comes to other game modes. They see the Ultimate Team and they say Ultimate Team is be all end all, it's the only option, don't play Ultimate Team, you're a fucking loser. A lot of people do think that way. I have a few friends who look down at me because I play career mode, not Ultimate Team. You know, I do play Ultimate Team. I do. I do play Ultimate Team. I just don't play it religiously. I mean, I play it from time to time, and then I get bored of it, and then I go back to career mode because I'm like, this is just not fun. I mean, if I put my mind to it, I could probably beat Smash Ultimate Team. But it would take several FIFAs of work because I still haven't gotten used to playing against someone who isn't sitting next to me. I mean,
quite as simple as you think to throw the ball to one of your
teams. If I played a person twice, say I played him once where we were in the same room with two controllers playing on the same game. Obviously playing on the same game, but as in, like, not playing on different consoles, playing on the same console. I'm player one, he's player two, or vice versa, if I'm on his console. I could smash him, no issue. But if we play and he's not in the same room as me, I don't know what it is. I just find it, you know, it's just different, you know? I don't know what it is. I've just never gotten used to playing against someone who I just can't, you know. I don't know where he is. I don't know where this person is. I don't know where he is, how he plays. Because if I play you on a regular basis, I've seen how you play, and I know, okay, he does this, and he does this, and he does that, and he does this. And I can counter, and I can come up with a strategy, and I can work a way to beat that person. But when they're in a different place, and it's always different people, because you can't guarantee it's the same person, unless they're on your friend list, and it's just a mess. It's just a mess. And I'm not saying that, you know, you shouldn't play Ultimate Team. Go ahead. I'm not going to stop you. I don't encourage not playing Ultimate Team. If you like playing Ultimate Team, fair play. But don't diss Career Mode. Career Mode, FIFA wouldn't be where it is today if not for Career Mode. That's just the hard fact. That is the hard fact. Career Mode, like, it is what FIFA was built on. It is. Because, you know, there never used to be pro clubs. There never used to be Ultimate Team or playing online. If you want to play someone, you have to be in the same fucking room as them. None of this playing online stuff. If I'm just playing a game on Ultimate Team. No, that's not how it works at all. That's how it works now, but it's not how it used to work. And, you know, I probably sound like I feel like I'm an old person, you know, complaining about, oh, things were much better in my day. Now, that's not the case. What I'm just saying is, career mode shouldn't be looked down on us because it is what made FIFA. It made FIFA. It did. And EA, if they don't realize that, they're idiots. They are blind. Because they forget that before Ultimate Team was selling copies off the shelf like ain't nobody's business, what was the cash grab? What made people want to buy FIFA year in and year out? It was career mode. Because there was no Ultimate Team, there was no clubs. And I feel like I'm repeating myself, but I'm making the point that people seem to forget. They seem to disregard that career mode is like the veteran game mode. It's the game mode that made FIFA what FIFA is today. FIFA would have died a death if not for career mode. Simple as that. If you dispute that, then you clearly have not been playing FIFA very long. Because if you've played FIFA before 2000 for a long, long time, then chances are you bought FIFA every single year or to play against your friend and to play against the computer. Now, almost no one plays against the computer. And if you want to play a friend, he has to be in your friend's list. And that's my rant about career mode being overlooked year in and year out by EA. I rethought last year was a sign that they were, going to take career mode and say, you know what? We do appreciate what you've done for this game mode. This game. So we will pump this game mode full of life. Let's make sure it doesn't slowly die, because that's what it's doing. These little, pretty much what you're doing, what EA do every year, is they give career mode a crutch. They give it a crutch and say, here you go, that's it, that's all you get. Career mode is fucking... Every year, career mode... Mode gets shafted over for Ultimate Team. Almost every single year. Since, like... Even last year. Actually, last year I think it was about even. Which it should be every single year. It should be about even. I mean, how much more can you really add to Ultimate Team? I mean, you could probably add a good bit. Was that Hugo Lloris? Hello? Oh no, it's all black. I thought that was fucking Hugo Lloris. I was like, what? Oh, Jesus Christ, how did that nearly go? That nearly went in! Anyway, back to my point. They've been doing over the past couple of years, except for last year, is giving career mode a crutch and saying, oh, you'll be fine. Like, every year, career mode is in a horrific car crash and is on freaking life support, and EA, instead of helping and pay for a surgery that could help revitalize and replenish the game mode and make it unbelievable and make it just as good and just as much as a reason to buy the game as Ultimate Team. Instead they say, here you go. This will give you another year to live. This will give you an extra year. Maybe. We don't know. If this keeps up, I could see them actually getting rid of career mode. I wouldn't bet against it, because they see this fucking cash cow giving fucking, instead of giving milk, it gives money, and that is Ultimate Team, and they're saying, why do we need, eventually, they're going to say, why do we need career mode? What does it do? I mean, what would happen? I don't know why I'd do it if FIFA does get rid of career mode, but I could see it happening. I mean, the only other alternative, as bad as the game is Pez is Master League, because technically it's the same thing. I don't know, I haven't really played it, but from what I can gather, because some of my friends do play Pez, as I say some, I mean two. They play Pez, and they've shown me Master League, and they say, oh, it's the exact same thing. And the Champions League is actually called the Champions League. I mean,
and then he goes with the tackle.
It would take some getting used to, but if I had to, I would switch to Pez if EA kills career mode. Which, what, it's neglecting? That's what it's doing. It is slowly killing career mode. And eventually, it's just gonna say, you know what, fuck it. Fuck career mode. What is it doing? It's not doing anything. It doesn't sell us any copies. Because they're fucking daft. I mean, they probably think club sells more or FIFA copies than career mode.
Gone out for a throw. Elneny.
EA, they just ignore career mode. And I don't understand why. It makes no sense. Like I said, FIFA would not be where it is without it. Simple was that.
That's a gift for them. It's an own goal.
If you are a long-term FIFA player, you played career mode at some point. Don't tell me you didn't. Because if you didn't, then that means you've been playing FIFA from 2009, or you're a bold-faced liar. Also, how was that Oblak's own goal? That was Mane's goal. Well, every day of the week. Hello? I mean, that is complete bullshit. That was going in.
Yeah, I mean, this home team will make it difficult, as will the crowd, but I don't think that will bother the visitors here.
He might be through. He's caught offside. Can you see what he's trying to do? It's all about the...
Yeah, I knew Mane was offside.
It's a bit too eager.
Mohamed Elneny. Another turnover in play here with that interception.
Oh, he's not offside this time. Sadio Mane! Set up Daniel Sturridge, 2-0, thank you very much, in additional time. Ride the wave, motherfucker! I mean, let me know in the let me know on Twitter what you think. Do you think EA would kill career mode? Because I think they would. If it thought, oh, you know, Ultimate Team makes us all the money. Why the fuck do we need career mode? I would not be surprised if that's how EA thinks. Sooner or later, they will get rid of career mode. And it'll be a very, very bad day. Now, I don't think this is going to happen anytime soon. At least I hope it doesn't happen anytime soon. I mean, I'd like to think EA PC can get... will give career mode another year of life support. I don't think they're gonna pull the plug yet, but eventually they will.
Elneny on the attack here. A lot of defenders between them and the goal, but they still got the ball. And this will be a goal kick. Can't get going, can't get into the game, Giroud. Can't keep the ball, Alan.
Well, with his team losing...
Like I said, it'll be a bad day.
Much more than they have so far.
Sturridge. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch.
Coutinho! Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
Punched away by the goalkeeper. That will be Liverpool's throw-in. Now Sadio Mane.
Mane. And for Sturridge, oh, I hit freaking 26 and went straight to the keeper.
Quick.
Stopper.
This particular date, EA Sports, we've got the presentation of the Premier League.
Freaking asshole. Dude. Sadio Mane. Go Sadio. Go Sadio. Sturridge. 3-0. Thank you very much. I will take a 3-0 lead, and that puts me in a very comfortable position to get all 3 points against Arsenal. Well, I think that's Sturridge's 10th goal of the season, putting him on double figures.
Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead.
Nice little accomplishment.
Substitution for Arsenal. Well, when they do say... You've been in these matches about the psychology of getting it right on the big day. You would have thought a bit nicely lined up for the
oh, bullshit!
All lined up in the right place.
Yes.
Coutinho.
Come on, hit him on the counter. Go, Manny, you've got the pace. Sadio Mane! Hey! I thought top right! Touch might take it out, freaking out of port! Americ! Hey man! Where's the love? Oh yes! That ball for Mane! He's clean through! Onside! He has his second goal. Technically, it's his first because he gave that first goal to the keeper as an own goal. If that's another own goal, I'm going to be pissed at you. Yeah, there we go. And that's actually Mane's 10th goal as well. Look at that. They are level again. Although Mane should be on 11. Because that first goal, that's Mane's goal. Well, it's the exact same as the one he just scored pretty much. How is that any different? Keeper makes a slight save. It doesn't mean it's not going in. It was going in. It wouldn't have gone in. You're saying it wouldn't have gone in without the touch the first time, but it was going in without the touch. It would have gone in despite the touch the second time. Sure. Oh, it's a straight red card for America Forte. It gets, it's going from bad to worse for Arsenal. Well, Dybala scores first. He's been clinical from the penalties, but that's a few he scored. Is it three penalties he's converted? I think that's four overall. He does have one in preseason, but that doesn't. I don't count that one. I think that's three.
The goal, wherever you look at it, it was very well taken.
This season.
If you're losing count, it's five.
So, that's pretty badass. That is a much better goal return than they got last year to be 100% lost. I make my substitutions before I forget. Sorry, I do have to make those substitutions because the board seemed to be a bit pissed off about something, and I have no idea what.
Shots on here.
Firmino! That was a bit of a hit and hop on there.
7 minutes to go. I'm nearly up here, and just throw it forward a bit to their next game. Great chance!
Oh, Moya could have scored another substitute goal himself, but he sets it up for Mane to get his second in the game. It should be his third. It should be a hat trick. But such is the way of this game. I mean, he lays it on a plate, and Sadio Mane is a very hungry person, and he does not leave a bit of food.
Well, the match a long time over here.
And no, oh, that's not because he's from Africa. Because I know there was someone thinking it. You know who you are. Or I guarantee it, there was somebody thinking, oh, he's making fun of the fact that he's out. No, no.
Well, it's not over yet because we've got four more minutes of added time to come.
Yeah, Phil. There's the full-time whistle. Oh, a solid victory. Hey, three goals from Sadio Mane. The game's not going to officially give him the hat-trick, but I'm going to give him the fucking hat-trick. A penalty score from Dalot, but a brace for Daniel Sturridge. All around, it was just a brilliant game. And that puts Arsenal in their place, doesn't it? Yeah. Next time they will think twice about thinking they have any business involving themselves in a title race, which really should only involve me at any point.
15 points.
Yes, I'm a dick, I realize that. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Special like button if you did subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.
City with 7 points. Fifth bottom, Hull City with 8 points.